Shastri ji lived like a common man, and he died a legend, almost in a blaze of glory. What do you think of him as a human being, first of all as a human being, then as a politician, prime minister?
Well, as a human being, I can do no better than quote Jawaharlal Nehru himself, who once said that what a great pride it was for him to have Shastri ji as one of his very senior colleagues. His simplicity, his commitment to the Gandhian ideals, and down-to-earth approach reflected in Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, I think these are legendary contributions to our nation-building activities that Shastri ji, during a short but very momentous period, made to the growth of our nation.
What would you say is his lasting legacy to India?
Well, to be a worthy successor to Jawaharlal Nehru was itself a formidable task for any ordinary human being. That Shastri ji lived up to that tough goal is a tribute to his qualities of head and heart.
How do you think he serves as a role model to today's day and age when politics is seen with so much cynicism and suspect?
Well, Shastri ji throughout his life stood for values. He resigned as railway minister when there was an accident. This exemplary commitment to public accountability is something which all politicians in office and out of office should emulate. His commitment to the welfare of the ordinary people famously enshrined his slogan of Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, I think is a testimony to his down-to-earth approach, his unusual capacity to sift essential from non-essential, to relate himself to the needs and aspirations of the common man or common woman. I think these were the hallmarks of his qualities as a great national leader.
And what about his Gandhian approach to life,
Well, the more I read about Gandhiji, the more I am convinced that Gandhiji, in many ways, was the most modern Indian of our age. And Shastri ji was a faithful follower, a deeply committed to Gandhian values of austerity, simplicity, high ideals, simple living, and high thinking. So he was in that great tradition of the stalwarts of freedom struggle, which included Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. So bliss was in that dawn to be alive.
What would you say were his contributions to nation building?
Well, in 1965, our nation faced a test in face of Pakistan attack on our country. Shastri ji provided exemplary leadership, and India came out victorious in that momentous incident in our nation's history. His period in office was short, but that agriculture is very important, that without agriculture we cannot prosper, that simultaneously we have to pay adequate attention to our defense. I think these are, I think, two enduring values which have not lost their relevance even today. India must be strong in its agriculture if it is to make social and economic progress. It cannot afford to neglect its defense in a world that we live in. And these are two lasting legacies of Shastri ji.
So would you attribute the success of the Green Revolution to Shastri ji in a big way?
Well, Shastri ji, the process was started by Pandit ji. Shastri ji carried it further. Then Mrs. Gandhi came, by that time the miracle seeds arrived. So it goes without saying that if the foundations were not laid by Jawaharlal Nehru, if Shastri ji had not, I think, built on those foundations, and if later on Indira ji did not show the determination to carry forward the Green Revolution, I think the results would not have been as good as they have turned out to be. Shastri ji, I think, made a great contribution in ushering in the agricultural revolution in our country.
Do you remember any story or anecdote that deeply affected you? You were that time not in mainstream politics. anything that inspired you?
Shastriji came from a very humble background, and I was told that even to go to a school he had to swim. So I think that tells you something about the man. When he died, he had no assets. He had a motor car that was also borrowed, and he had yet to pay his debt. Such was the life, the examples that he set for future politicians.
I believe Shastriji appointed an administration reforms commission headed by Morarji Desai because he believed that there should be fundamental changes in the laws of the land. There should not be that aura around the bureaucracy, and that the Aam Aadmi should feel connected to government. I mean, what are your views on this? Because I think you are thinking of similar changes in administrative reform.
Administering a country of India's size and India's complexity is not an easy task. And whether our administrative systems, procedures are in tune with the requirements of our time, this is a quest which I think has to be pursued from time to time. Shastriji started that process. Successive governments have also worked in that direction. But even today, I feel that there is a need for major reforms in our administrative system to make it more accountable, to make it more efficient, and also to promote public-private partnership to a much greater extent than has been the case thus far.
My last thing is, how would you sum up Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan? Does it still resonate in the minds of the Indian people? Does it, inspire the youth to join the army, for us to have the Kisan as the backbone of our nation?
Well, I think India cannot prosper if its Kisans are not happy. India cannot prosper if its defense is neglected. So in that way, the prosperity of Kisans, the welfare of our soldiers are of eternal value. They are as valuable today as they were when Shastriji coined this famous slogan of Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan.
Thank you very much, Mr. Prime Minister.